Hello and welcome to Rajya Sabha TV's coverage of the FIFA World Cup 2018. I'm your host, Frank Pereira. Yesterday too was not a day for the minnows or the underdogs. The favourites of Group C and Group D too have advanced to the next round of the tournament. We'll talk about that later on in the programme. But first, of course, let's preview today's matches. Four matches in all will be played today. Germany's advance in the next round will be decided when they take on South Korea in the last match of Group F. In a match to be played simultaneously, Sweden will clash with Mexico in a must-win game to go to the next round.
Germany will meet South Korea at the Kazan Arena in a short while from now, a game they need to win big to qualify for the round of 16. The four-time world champions' advance will also be affected by the result of the game between Mexico and Sweden that is being played simultaneously. Germany is now in second place in Group F behind Mexico, which defeated them in the opener. Scoring a nerve-wracking final-minute victory against Sweden in their second group game has raised expectations within the ranks that the team will go all the way through.
Wenn es wahrscheinlich, wie es angekündigt ist, 30 Grad hat, dann ist ja klar, dass natürlich auch das eine Rolle spielt. Ich glaube, wir haben aber jetzt in beiden Spielen in der zweiten Halbzeit gegen Mexiko oder dann auch gegen Schweden gezeigt, dass wir schon auch aufs Tempo spielen können, auch wenn es ein bisschen wärmer ist.
It will once again be banking on the brilliance of Toni Kroos and Marco Reus, the two who scored the goals against Sweden to price out a victory and avoid elimination from the World Cup in the group stage, something that had happened 80 years ago. Good news for Germany is that their ace central defender Mats Hummels has recovered from a neck injury and will be fit for the match. However, midfielder Sebastian Rudi is doubtful. The world champions must win this game by at least two goals to make sure to get a spot in the second round. And history is loaded in their favour as they have never been defeated by the South Koreans. The other match in Yekaterinburg between Mexico and Sweden will decide the final composition of Group F. The match is a must-win for Sweden for them to stand a chance to go through to the round of 16.
Lördag så att vi klarar av att matcha regerande mästarna faktiskt ända in i mål förutom de sista 10 sekunderna. Så att det är en match som stärker självförtroendet, inget annat för vår del. Vi går in i morgondagens match med en stark tro på att vi kan göra en topprestation igen som vi har visat nu några gånger att vi har gjort.
Currently Sweden is tied with Germany on 3 points with an equal goal difference. They too need to defeat Mexico by at least 2 goals, a scenario that may also jeopardize Mexico's chances if Germany wins big. A draw would be enough for Sweden if Germany lose to South Korea. Both Mexico and Sweden are highly matched teams with 9 matches between them, of which only one has been in a World Cup, won by Sweden way back in 1958. Raj Yadav's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, let's now take a look at the Group F tally and see how the teams are placed in this particular group. All, permutations and combinations are possible. Only South Korea are out of the equation. Joining me in the studio right now are Nilanjan Datta, senior sports journalist, and Jyoti Barrett, former Indian national player. Nilanjan, looking at that group table there, 3 teams have a chance of going into the next round. There are only 2 spots, however.
Yeah, good. It's good that 3 teams are alive. So then the last day, it's not only between those 2 teams. I feel we will be happy seeing a different kind of a Germany today. The original Germany, the goal the other day from Toni Kroos at the last moment could not have come at a better time. You know what this kind of goal does? It brings back the confidence in the team. You need to remember this is the World Cup. A World Cup journey for any team, whoever it may be, can end in 3 matches. So In a situation where you lose the first match, doubts start creeping in. And that kind of a goal gives you back the confidence. The players started believing in themselves. The players try fancy their chances, what they are known for. Some long ranger shots, some one-to-one situations they may do. There's too much of talent in this German squad. I believe Germany have not awakened from their slumber as yet. They are destined to maybe, if not win, go deep into the tournament.
Okay, go deep into the tournament is what London is predicting as far as Germany is concerned. You know, Jyoti, as far as this German team is concerned, or for that matter, all these top teams, most of the favourites that we thought wouldn't make it have made it. That's why, you know, you look at Group A, Group B and the other groups as well. So expecting Germany to go through today.
Yeah, I mean, that is what makes them the good teams. They somehow know when to peak, and I can see Germany I'm sure they didn't want to get off to the start, they did. But they're professionals, they're experienced enough to know when to really step on the gas. And, you know, it's the German side, they're going to be efficient. I can see them winning today.
Sure, let's look at the formation as far as the teams are concerned. Germany first, of course, expected to play a 4-2-3-1 kind of a formation today. They will be missing the services of Jerome Boateng, of course, who is suspended from this particular match. But they do have a quality side. Someone else will come in for him. Four at the back, two defensive midfielders, three out-and-out midfielders and one centre-forward is what Germany is going with today. We'll look at South Korea's formation as well now on your screens. You know, as far as South Korea is concerned, they too are expected to play a 4-2-3-1 kind of a formation. And as far as their team is concerned, Cho will be in goal. They have Lee Jang Kim, Kim Joo Ki, Moon Lee Wang and Son. Let's take a look at some of the players to watch out for as well as far as today's match is concerned. Germany, of course, desperately needed the services of Toni Kroos in the previous match to come out victorious. All eyes on Toni Kroos once again today, Nilanjan?
Yeah, absolutely. Why not? Big players play on the big day. That's the difference between a great player and a good player. And that free kick off, if you compare the two teams, Germany versus South Korea, what happens is these German players day in and day out play in those European leagues, which has the best talent available from all over the world. So they have been in situations day in, day out, they do it each and every day. On the other hand, the South Korean players or any Asian team player, maybe of the same caliber, but that kind of pressure they do not face each and every day. That's the subtle difference, and that subtle difference is a huge difference for me in the World Cup.
But Germany cannot count out South Korea. They are an experienced side. They are one of the top sides in Asia. And on their best day, they can upset anyone. If Germany has a bad day against the South Koreans, they can make them pay.
Yeah, their defense is going to have to be careful. You know, no sort of lapses in concentration today at all. And that's something that could cost them heavily. Because I'm sure they want to top this group and they want to do it well. So, of course, you know, they are going to have to go out there and they can't afford to, you know, switch off for even a second.
Indeed. Let's look at the other match that will be played simultaneously, of course. Mexico versus Sweden. The formation, as far as Mexico is concerned, they're most likely to play a 4-4-1-1 kind of a formation. And as far as the team news is concerned, Mexico will play Ochoa in goal. Alvarez, Salcedo, Moreno, Gallardo, Dos Santos, Herrera, Godado, Lozano, Vela and Hernandez. That is the team as far as Mexico is concerned. And we look at the Swedish team as well after this, of course, where Sweden is expected to play a traditional 4-4-2 kind of a formation. Olsen in goal. Lustig, of course, Lindelof, Granqvist, Augustinsson, Claesson, Larsson, Ekdal, Forsberg, Toivonen and Berg will make up the playing 11 as far as Sweden is concerned. Nilanjan, another important match as far as this group is concerned, Mexico versus Sweden. Mexicans have played free-flowing football. They've surprised us all in this particular tournament and we've enjoyed watching them play.
Absolutely.
In this tournament as well.
Why not? It's the kind of a golden generation of the Mexican players. 2012 London Olympics, many a boy from this squad was in that gold medal winning squad. They have now graduated, maybe playing at their prime. the counter-attacks, the entire world has watched how the Mexicans counter-attack. 1, 2, 3, 4 touches in a split of 3 to 4 seconds from one side of the box to the other. That too without any long ball. Means that's amazing talent.
And they have aging players as well, despite that they're doing this.
Absolutely. That speaks about the fitness levels, because fitness levels in modern day football is absolutely, stays the bedrock of the success of any team. The work rate of the players is amazing. Mexico are a good side to watch. Have not been tested that much. Tend to open up much, depending on the counter attack. They can afford to sit back and relax. For Sweden, it's a must win.
And as far as Sweden is concerned, what can we expect, Jyoti? Do you think they're going to go all out? I mean, what should Mexico be wary of?
Sweden will go all out. I mean, they're not going to play the same way they did against Germany. But of course, that showed us how strong they are defensively to hold the world champions for so long. But Sweden are obviously going to be on the attack today. They need to win. And Mexico need a bit wary of that because, they haven't been tested, as we just said. But I can expect them to play their natural game, free-flowing. I'm particularly looking forward to seeing young Lozano play again. He's someone who's impressed me so far.
Sure, all right. Let's look at the other matches of the day to be played. Late night starts at 11:30 p.m. here in India. The two teams to go into the round of 16 from Group E will be decided then. On the final day of action in Serbia, of course, will meet Brazil, and Switzerland will play against Costa Rica.
Five times world champions Brazil sit on top of Group E with 4 points, along with Switzerland, while Serbia have 3 points. If Serbia wants to go into the round of 16, they must win the match against Brazil at Moscow's Spartak Stadium. The team has hopefully recovered from the late heartbreaking 2-1 loss to Switzerland in their second group match. Serbia can make do even with a draw if Costa Rica beats the Swiss in the other match. The team feels all the pressure is on Brazil, and therefore the dream is still very much alive.
Ne dat sebe u 90 minuta, znači jednostavno pokušat igrat protiv sile kakva je brazilska fudbalska sila, nemam zdrav nikakav. Suština je samo da odigramo maksimalno angažovano, strpljivo, disciplinovano, da budemo tim kao što smo bili tim.
Brazil, on the other hand, have not displayed the play that they are known for. They were held to a 1-1 draw by Switzerland before a late rally earned them a 2-0 win over Costa Rica. The team will have to do without winger Douglas Costa, who was injured against Costa Rica. The team will also be banking on Felipe Coutinho, who has scored 2 of their 3 goals so far.
Mas não tem, e essa não tem, isso eu posso te assegurar. Não tem busca de... Tem é a qualidade da Sérvia, ela chegar aqui pelos méritos que teve, a vitória que teve, a qualidade do Ivanovic, a qualidade do Kolarov, a qualidade do
Mitrovic, Milinkovic,
do Matic.
In the other match, Switzerland will meet Costa Rica. The Swiss have shown exceptional resilience this World Cup, managing to make crucial comebacks in both their group matches. A draw is all they need against the Costa Ricans to proceed to the next round. Switzerland have history on their side. On each of the 2 previous occasions that the teams have met, the Swiss have been victorious.
Wichtigste für alle zusammen ist Fußball, und wir leben alle hier, wir vom Fußball, von Emotionen, und im Fußball sollte auch Emotionen sein, und ich gehe mit dieser Gedanke, da das, was passiert, ist passiert.
However, Costa Rica will do their best to avoid returning home empty-handed. Having lost to Serbia by just a single goal and holding firm until stoppage time against Brazil, they will be relying on their defense, but it's also time for the strikers to step up. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, let's first take a look at the Group E tally now and see how the teams are placed in this particular group. Brazil, of course, on top with 4 points, but along with them is Switzerland with 4 points as well. Serbia on 3, Costa Rica no points at all. They are out of this tournament. Let's take a look at how the teams will line up as well today. First, let's take a look at Brazil, of course. Becker is in goal. Fagner, Silva, Miranda, Marcelo, Casemiro, Paulinho, Coutinho, Willian, Neymar and Jesus will make up the playing 11 as far as Brazil is concerned. Let's take a look at the Serbian team now and the possible lineup, starting lineup for this particular match will be Stojkovic in goal, Ivanovic, Milenkovic, Tosic, Kolarov, Milivojic, Matic, Tadic, Sergej, Ljajic and Mitrovic will make up the playing 11. And as far as the formations are concerned, Brazil is expected to play a 4-1-2-3 kind of a formation in this particular game with four defenders, one defensive midfielder, two midfielders and three forwards with one centre forward. And as far as Serbia is concerned, Serbia is expected to play a 4-2-3-1 kind of a formation, four at the back, two defensive midfielders, three of course in front of those two defensive midfielders and one out and out forward. Brazil versus Serbia, the match to look out for as far as this group is concerned
without,
for the night?
Without any doubt. Brazil are playing when they play the entire world watches. They play to entertain and in the process of entertaining, they go on to win matches effortlessly. But this Brazilian team is not entertaining and they have to win. When have Brazil ever in the history of World Cup been in a situation like this? If you don't win, you're out of the maybe the World Cup in the first round itself. Anxiety and pressure on the faces of all the Brazilian players. I don't know where is it coming from, because you do not need to push too much of pressure on yourself. Coutinho, I believe so, needs to be given a more of a flexible role, freedom given his creativity. That can work wonders for
him. He should be a floater rather than a
fixed. I believe so.
Sure. You know, Jyoti, as far as Serbia are concerned, you know, they've been unlucky to be in this position. They should have probably won their previous match or at least drawn for that matter. But they could cause the Brazilians some trouble.
Yeah, definitely. Serbia has been a side that I think people are underrating because they won the first game narrowly and then the second game they lost out unluckily to Switzerland in late goal. Two late goals. But, you know, they're a side that has shown that they are quality and Brazil needs to take them seriously today because they're a side that can really stun them. They have the quality.
They do have the quality and the Brazilians will have to be careful as far as the Brazilians are concerned. Like Nilanjan was talking about, Philippe Coutinho will be the player to watch out for. He's been brilliant at the club level, of course. He scored that goal in the previous match as well, a late goal just before Neymar scored an even later goal. 26 years of age, 38 matches and 12 goals is what he has scored. And as far as the Serbian player to watch out for is Alexander Mitrovic, 23 years of age, 40 matches, 17 goals. Let's talk about the other late night match now between Switzerland and Costa Rica. As far as Switzerland's team is concerned, the lineup of course is Sommer in goal, Litzsteiner, Scher, Akanji, Rodriguez, Berami, Shaka, Zemali, Shaqiri, Zubair and Seferovic. And we'll take a look at the Costa Rican lineup as well. There's Keylor Navas, Acosta, Gonzalez, Duarte, Gamboa, Oviedo, Borges, Guzman, Venegas, Bryan and Urena. This will be this possible starting lineup, of course, as far as Costa Rica is concerned. Now let's take a look at the formations of the two teams. Switzerland first on our screens right now. We have a 4-2-3-1 kind of a formation as far as the Swiss are concerned. Four defenders, two defensive midfielders, three attacking midfielders and one out and out forward. Let's take a look at the other team now, Costa Rica, on our screens. You know, these are the players as far as Costa Rica is concerned. They're going to go ahead with a 3-2-2-1 kind of a formation where, of course, there'll be three defenders, out-and-out central defenders, and, of course, the others, midfielders and an out-and-out striker as well. Costa Rica versus Switzerland, Nilanjan, of course, Costa Rica are out of this tournament, but all to play for the Swiss because they'll want to top this group.
Absolutely, and such teams like Costa Rica are very dangerous. They would be fearless, have nothing to lose, but somehow I feel a three-man defense against this Swiss attack may be a bit dicey, and then Keylor Navas has to be one of the busiest men on the ground because the wing play of the Switzerland match style has been they spread it through the wings. A three-man defense can be a bit tricky.
Sure, and as far as the players to watch out for, as far as this match is concerned for the Swiss, it's clearly Shaqiri, 26 years of age, 72 matches, 21 goals. You happy with the way Shaqiri has played thus far, Jyoti?
Very impressive. I mean, he was involved in everything in their last game, and he always seems to be in the right place at the right time. He's someone who's hungry for goals, and he's going to make a big difference for them.
Okay, all right. He's going to make a big difference for them is what Jyoti is saying. Of course, he's played tremendously well so far in the tournament, and we wish him all the best to go on probably deep into the tournament as well. On that note, we'll slip into a short break now. On the other side, we'll review the matches that took place last night. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.